Joe. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the Atlanta Braves and the Washington Nationals. It's Nationals baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Max Scherzer gets the ball for Washington in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Max Scherzer. Hello, Chief. It's Max, and it's not Agent 99. This is one of the best pitchers in the game of baseball. Upper to mid-90s fastball, powerhouse slider, and a great changeup. If he brings his A game, it's lights out for the opposing team.
Acuna digs in now. He will lead this one off today. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball.
First pitch, 4 o'clock.
Here's the 0-1. Ah, and he takes something off there and had him way out in front for strike two. Slider strike three called as the leadoff man is set down looking to open up the ball game.
That's what you call clipping the outside corner. Great movement on that slider, and it completely locked up the hitter. Didn't fool the umpire, though.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman, as he will look at a curveball right on the black, apparently. It's strike one. Past battles with Scherzer, he's gone 3 for 8. One out, nobody on. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Scherzer is what you may call a stingy starting pitcher. He rarely gets hit around, and on top of that, he usually excels at limiting free passes. A great combination to have.
Matty V, I think one of the keys to being a good starting pitcher, one, limiting the number of pitches that you throw into a game, and two, getting outs as quickly as you can. And there aren't too many guys that do it better than this guy. Not a lot of pitches. One of the things I like, he's in attack mode from the first pitch of every at bat.
And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Here's Marcell Ozuna. As he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle, it's 0-1. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Here's the pitch. Fouled off. Bases are empty here with two men out. And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now.
He didn't look overly fooled right there, because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out the side in order. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. It's on to the bottom of the first. No score on the show. Drew Smyly out of the state of Arkansas is on the hill here. What's your take on him, Dan?
Yeah, he's had some arm injuries, but when this guy's healthy, as good as anybody in the game of baseball from the left side. Good fastball, not overpowering, 92 to 94. Good assortment of breaking pitches. Holds runners really well. Has a good pickoff move. A good pitcher when he's healthy. This is really one of the top pitchers in the game.
So digging in now, Victor Robles. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. No balls and one strike. And a curveball taken for strike two. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Pitching 101 is changing location and upsetting the hitter's timing. You do that and everything's going to be fine. In that strikeout, he never threw the same pitch twice in a row, and he won the battle because of it.
Here now is Juan Soto. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. And now pitch on the way.
Gonna be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
And there is our officiating crew in this one, calling balls and strikes, Mr. Freddie Ferguson.
Hey, D-Row, you better be ready to swing, particularly at that low pitch. Freddie Ferguson, low ball umpire.
Yeah, makes it tough on the offense. I was a guy who liked the low ball, but that usually means those guys are susceptible to that slider in the dirt. You have to see the ball up, and this guy doesn't give you a chance.
Got a piece. It's 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Trey Turner is on deck. Skied down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. And he missed with that one. It's ball four. A one-out walk here in the home first.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Striding in now for the Nats, Trey Turner. He'll get to take his first cuts here. From the belt, kicks and deals. First pitch fastball runs a bit too high. It's ball one. Soto, base runner at first with one out. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, dealer in a spot like that, that's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Josh Bell the next to hit. As he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. Count even at 1-1 to the Nationals' first baseman. First and second now, one man out. It's two balls and a strike to Josh Bell.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
A 2-1 home.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
The 3-1. Swung on and missed. A full count now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Drilled right back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Long throw to third. But too late, and he's safe at third. And the run will score as the Nats are off to a 1-0 lead.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D-Roy. Get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
At the plate now, Kyle Schwarber, as he'll take a look at ball one.
This is exactly the situation you drew up from an offensive standpoint. Pitcher on the mound, but you got a chance to bury him early in this one.
One and one to Schwarber.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
The 2-1 home. Two balls and two strikes now. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. In now for Washington, Starlin Castro. He's set, here it comes. Hit hard to the right side. Foul.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at one. Hit out to Albies at second base. He's got it. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. Sights and sounds of a day at the ballpark. Oh my goodness. Don't touch that dial or the remote for that matter. More on the show right after this. And now the Atlanta number four hitter, Travis d'Arnaud. And he'll lead things off against Max Scherzer. First pitch of the at bat. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
Hey, this offense better be prepared to pull a trigger. This starter is known to be aggressive and come right after you.
Oh, and one count and the pitch. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Boy, he's really on a roll in the hill right now. As we roll through it again, remember, he struck out the side in the last inning, and now he picks up right where he left off by striking off the leadoff man here. Let's see if he can keep this going for a little bit.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring up Ozzie Albies. Here comes the first pitch.
Ball one.
Well, he punched out the last guy, but he didn't get any favors from the blue on the first pitch in this at bat. Probably should be ahead of this hitter instead of behind.
One out, nobody on. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now. Fouled away. The 2-1. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2. Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Dansby Swanson lining up to hit as he'll lay off a curveball in the dirt for ball one. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. To first, Bell picks it up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Braves. It remains 1-0. Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
The catcher, Yan Gomes.
First pitch on its way. A high fastball is in there. Swing and a miss, and he's in the hole 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
One ball, two strikes.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
Come on, Dad. Go.
Here now the 2-2. Locks him up for strike three.
Great spot on that 2-2 fastball. You can't place it on the inside corner any better than that. As a hitter, there's just not a whole lot you can do with that unless you're looking for it and time it just right. Love seeing a guy that can work the inside with his fastball.
Carter Kieboom digs in now as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out.
That ball is fast.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there, a little bit too far out in front. Gotta find a way to keep his hands back.
That nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out. Into the box now, the Nationals pitcher, Max Scherzer. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Just the second inning, but already 37 pitches to this point. Comes back with a good changeup there, and it's quickly 0-2. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. And the pitch. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Three up, three down for Washington. We've played two innings. It's 1-0. The next to bat for Atlanta, Austin Riley. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Pitch on the way.
Count 1-0.
The 1-0. And it's 1-2.
Not likely to see a fourth fastball in this situation. I'm going to eliminate the fastball if I'm at the plate right here.
And a swing and a miss as he picks up yet another strikeout. Six of them already, and there's one gone in the inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box, Christian Pache. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. Braves are still looking to break into the hit column here. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
Pitch on the way. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And he fouls this one off. One out, nobody on. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
Boy, he's got great stuff today, doesn't he? That's seven punch outs now here in the middle innings. He's up over one in the inning up to this point. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can change their plan of attack and start to put the ball in play. But right now, that's just not happening.
Stepping in now, Drew Smyly. A ball and no strikes. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. The 1-0 is taken for ball two.
Can't fall behind against the pitcher. Need to minimize pitch count against the easy outs, and this is certainly one of them.
Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss on what should have been ball three. Instead, the count goes to 2-1.
Oh, man, was that a hack. He's trying to create his own run support with a swing like that.
And it's fouled away. Here now the 2-2. And he pops him up, drifting toward the left side of the infield. Keboom puts the glove to it, and the side is retired. Make it nine straight here to start the ball game. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. Washington leads this one 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and digging in is the outfielder, Victor Robles. Here's the first pitch to him. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. And he won't take any chances on that one as this is scooped away in foul territory for the first strike. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
If I'm in the box, you take a step out right here. Take a deep breath after that high fastball. You got to be leery of him burying something in the dirt.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two. hit hard down the line. And this gets past him at third as it hugs the line. A fair ball. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
Looking at this, you know he had to be sitting on that pitch because he jumped all over it. Tried to keep him off balance with the old Uncle Charlie, and he was having none of that. Not a bad pitch. He was just waiting for it and blasted a leadoff double.
Striding in once again, Juan Soto. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. First offering on its way. And he gets ahead 0-1.
Like that pitch there. Lefty on lefty matchup. Curveball away to a lefty. Smart pitch.
Yanked hard but foul to the right. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Fastball well outside.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball. Not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
The 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. A runner at second, nobody out. And he looks at a cold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one.
The
man at second with one down, and that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. Two and one, the count to Trey Turner. Three and one to the National shortstop.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Three and two. Runner at second here with one man out. And there's a line drive, base hit to left field. The throw to the plate. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump, but this guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling baseballs. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good about it.
First things first, here's a throw over. And a dive, but he's back in. So that'll bring up Josh Bell. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. From the belt, the pitch, a pitch out, the throw, not in time as he's able to thwart the pitch out.
I'm not sure what else the defense could have done there. They pitched out and the throw was pretty good, but they still couldn't cut him down. You kind of just have to hope he gets a bad jump.
The 2-0 on the way.
Love the fact the pitcher challenged him in that spot right there. Didn't love the location.
But I got to be honest with you, I think he's got him on his heels right now. Don't be shocked if he attacks the zone again.
Now the 2-1. And the runner's breaking for third. Strike called. Now the throw down is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
You know, I was pretty surprised to see him on the move to third because it didn't seem like he had that much of a lead. But he made it work out. That was really impressive.
Here now the 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Yeah, the pitching coach would hate to go to the bullpen this early in the game, but sometimes you have no choice. On the flip side, he might just get in his face a little bit out there, try to challenge him, wake him up from his funk. Either way, we'll see how it works.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kyle Schwarber looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Fouled off. And there's ball one. A little bit outside. 2-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
I got 3-1. Three balls, one strike.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit in now. 3-1, 2-on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone. So you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
So here's Starlin Castro, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. The 1-0 pulls this one in the air out to left. Ozuna is under it. He makes the catch. Here comes the runner from third. And that'll bring home run number three. It's now a 3-0 cushion.
Obviously, he's hoping for more up there with the bases loaded, but you can't be too upset with the sac fly.
Two men on, two out, and that means the catcher Yan Gomes bats next. Looking to minimize the damage here. Curveball looked at here for strike one.
We're only in the third inning, and his pitch count is above 60. That's not being too efficient with your pitches.
Smiley comes set. Here's the 0-1.
Ball one. 1-1.
Let's go, Nats. Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Struck him out, so he's set down on strikes for the second time today. So two runs on two hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. On now to the top of inning number four. It's the Nationals 3 and the Braves nothing. And here's Ronald Acuna Jr. now back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Here's the pitch. And that's by him. It's 0-1.
I'd like to see this lineup start working the count a little bit more and drive up this pitcher's pitch count.
Fouled away. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Got him. And that's 8 strikeouts now for him in the ballgame.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? What's even more impressive, no walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
So next up will be Freddie Freeman. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-0 home is laid off for ball two. No runs, no hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Hit sharply on the ground. Castro's got it. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. And that'll bring in Marcell Ozuna. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Here comes the first pitch. Hit on the ground out to short. Turner fields it cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Braves are set down 1-2-3. They trail in this one 3-0. And back in our nation's capital, before we get too much further on the field, let's check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Nationals manager Dave Martinez between innings, specifically about his club's offense to this point.
And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They've already worked out 3 walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And in steps Carter Kieboom to give it a try.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one.
I guess the game plan from the offensive standpoint today coming into this one was they were going to work the counts. They've been super patient at the plate in the early goings of this game, and they've got the lead looking for more.
1-1 the count now. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone.
Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2. And the pitch. Right, heading out towards shallow right. Acuna giving chase. Oh, and a great diving catch for the first down.
Oh, and a highlight reel catch there, no doubt. He laid out to sacrifice his body, brought it in, and secured it all the way to the ground. You know his pitcher really appreciates an effort like that.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up one of the better hitting pitchers in Max Scherzer. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Hey. 0-1's the count.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1.
The count, 1-1. That's ball two.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
Bases are empty, one man out. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. And this pitch is popped straight up right around the home plate area. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two. Victor Robles digging in now. First pitch coming. Here it is.
You have to be careful. You can't sleep on the bunt right here, even with two outs. They're playing him back. But this guy can handle the bat.
And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway. This is line to left. Ozuna is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Nationals gone in order, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the Braves' offense with their manager, Brian Snicker, during the commercial break.
And he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
All right, thanks, Heidi. First delivery to him on the way. Travis d'Arnaud will stand in for a second time here as he swings and misses there. It's nothing and one. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole 0-2. D'Arnaud, the former New York Met, who was signed as a free agent in the middle of last season.
Yeah, I know he expected to get a longer-term deal, but these are the facts right now. He is on a one-year deal, and he is going to have to produce if he is going to get that multi-year he's been looking for come offseason.
I love a well-executed changeup, especially one down in the zone. The only problem throwing it in that situation, you leave that belt high or miss your spot just a hair, and you could have some problems.
The 2-2. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And foul.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Bell is there for it. He's got it one away.
Now batting.
Digging in to try it again, Ozzie Albies, last year's recipient of the Silver Slugger Award for NL second baseman. 50th pitch of the game on its way.
Ball left outside.
One out, nobody on. Albies with a 1-1 count now. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. is a called third strike down in the zone.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. As Scherzer's able to move ahead of him with strike one, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. God, he looks like he's toying with him here. It's 0-2.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from five shutout innings.
There's a drive out to left center field. Around first, he's digging for second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
I'll tell you, that's one of the first good swings we've seen anybody put on this guy so far. He's been throwing the ball really well, but that was one of the few mistakes we've seen him make.
At the plate, Austin Riley, as the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Ball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Two balls and a strike to count. Two and two.
That's a really nice thing about pitching with the base open. You could work out of the strike zone a little bit more and try to get a guy to chase your pitch just like that one.
No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for Atlanta. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. The three of us are back after this message and a word from our local stations. Sean Newcomb, the 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now.
Number 18, Sean Newcomb.
Juan Soto to the plate now. He'll lead things off as we begin the home fifth. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. There's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone. Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. Here's the pitch. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. And so now the Braves will get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. The 2-1 is laid off of for ball number three.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And eesh, not the kind of swing you're looking for. 3-1 as it runs to a full count now. 3-2. A swing, and this one is blasted to right field. Nothing's gonna stop it. Into the second deck and gone. solo shot here to straightaway right field. And the Nationals have now taken a 4-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
Here now is Trey Turner. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. The 1-0 home. Bases are empty here, nobody out. Up and in. Big danger now. It's 3-0.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal a base on you. But if you lay a fastball in there, he can take you deep, too.
3-1.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
The 3-1. And he takes a big swing here, but this winds up a little tapper to the left of the mound. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Boy, when things are good, things are going really good. How about a swinging bunt infield single right there for his third knock of the game, D-Row?
Yeah, he has to be feeling frisky right now. He's had two great at-bats, and then this one, he's 100% on fire. Getting an infield single for his third knock of the game, that's awesome.
Delivery to him on the way. Josh Bell is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1.
Yeah, he made up his mind early to take the first pitch because that thing was right down the middle.
And he watches a called strike at the knees. No balls and two strikes.
Two takes and now he's down 0-2. I'm not sure, but he may have been taking to give a guy at first a chance to run.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Now a throw over, a dive, but he's back. So now to the plate, Kyle Schwarber. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Runners on first with one down. Throw over to the bag, runners back. Strike taken up in the zone. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
2-1 the count. From the belt, kicks and deals, and it's fouled away. Runner at first here, one man out. And now they've got him picked off. And a good decision to throw as he is toast at second base. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Never tempted to swing at that ball down low, it's ball three. Fastball too high, ball four.
Well, it's obvious that earlier home run he gave up is still on his mind. He had him 3-2, but he didn't want to give him anything over the heart of the plate to hit, so we'll see if that walk comes back to hurt him.
Here's Starlin Castro. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Breaking ball for a strike. 0-1. Has a look. Now the pitch. Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Boy, this has been a tough one for him so far, D-Roll. Seventh hit of the game already. They're really making him work.
Yeah, 100%, Dan. As Dustin Pedroia says, it's a laser show out there.
To the plate now, Yan Gomes. And he takes ball one. No hits to this point. The 1-0 now to Gomes. Lifted down the line and left. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
The 2-1 home. That's popped up. Albies ranging into the outfield. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. Nationals able to add on thanks to the long ball. We're through five here this afternoon. It's 4-0 Washington. Stepping in for the Braves, Christian Pache. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Fastball was too much for him there. Swung right through it.
Well, you know you've got it working on the mound when they're swinging right through it, even when you're putting it right down the middle of the strike zone. Not the greatest of game plans, though.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Left fielder is on the move. He's there and records the first out. Ender Inciarte will move into the on deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Inciarte. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Swing and a hard hit ball down the line in right. And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
Well, the pitcher can't really worry about that one. I mean, it was only their second hit of the game, so he's doing a lot of things right. Let's see if he can leave him out there now.
In now, Ronald Acuna. Fouled off. 0-2 for him to this point. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
Well, tried to throw a high fastball right by him there. Didn't work, but now we'll see if that sets up some different options. Wouldn't be surprised to see a good slider down and away right here.
Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time.
No hitter is ever going to feel good about taking the hat trick with three strikeouts in a game, but I will say he's not the first guy to have a terrible game against my man on the mound, and you know what? He won't be the last. We all know he's one of the best in the business for a reason.
Into the box, Freddie Freeman. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. The 1-0 pitch is offered at and missed for the first strike.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. Gone! A two-run blast off the bat of Freddie Freeman, and the Braves have cut things to a 4-2 score.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
Standing in now, Marcell Ozuna. As he'll take a look at ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. The 1-0 home is a fastball that misses.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. Not being very aggressive right now.
3-0 now.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
High and deep down the left field line. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. And he's way off balance with the swing there.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. Again, he sends it out of play. On the ground to third. Throw on to Bell at first, and the side is retired. The two in the inning for Atlanta, both coming on this two-run home run. Through 5.5, it's the Nationals 4 and the Braves 2. Jacob Webb enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Braves, number 64, Jacob Webb.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Carter Kieboom.
The third baseman, number 8.
He's set, and the pitch. And they start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. The 1-0 home misses, ball two. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. And the throw will be too late, so it's a bunt single to get him started here.
The pitcher, number 31, Matt Turner.
Into the box now, Max Scherzer. And he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. One, here's the pitch. And it's 1-1. The 1-1 home is strike two swinging.
I'm interested to watch this next pitch right here. He got a swing on a high fastball. I wonder if he's going to pull the old Plesac and climb the ladder.
1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. 3-2 pitch is at the knees and called strike three.
Now I know he struck out there, but for a pitcher, that's a pretty solid at bat. Anytime you can make an opposing pitcher out there work and throw quite a few more extra pitches, that's a quality AB in my book.
At the plate now, Victor Robles. Pitch outside, the throw. Offline throw, but they still got him. Good job of getting the tag down there.
This throw wasn't a perfect one. It kind of made the fielder reach across his body to make the catch, but the runner got a pretty awful jump, and it really killed him that time.
We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. Counts even at 1-1 to Victor Robles. Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. And he'll try to hold up in time, but to no avail as he went around and the inning is over. Nothing doing for Washington, but they still lead this one 4-2. Digging in once again, Travis d'Arnaud, 0-2 for him to this point.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast. They could certainly use that right now.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
1-0.
Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Swing and a miss. Looked like a slider there. A ball and a strike. Saw his eyes light up that time, but he swung at a bad one there.
Even though we're late into this ball game, this guy's velo is still top notch. This guy's a horse.
The 1-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzy Albies. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. No hits to this point. This one's too far inside, ball two.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
Something that stood out to me in this game is the lineup's lack of a solid plan at the plate. Seems like way too many guys are chasing pitches out of the zone and trying to hit pitchers like that one down and away. There's no success in that.
Seventh inning here at the ballpark, 4-2 our score. Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count. Do you sit changeup, or do you stay with the heater?
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Ozzie Albies takes his third strikeout of the day. So now to the plate, Dansby Swanson. As he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Two and oh, the count to Dansby Swanson. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He's through first and hustling for second. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
Here's the fourth hit of the game, and it's a good one. Puts a good swing on this thing, and it goes for a double. We'll see if they can build on it here.
To the plate now, Austin Riley, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
Hey, sometimes you have to look at it like it's not how or how many. Pitching very well into this one into the late innings, and his first pitch strike percentage less than 50%. He'd like it to be a lot higher than that. He's making it very difficult on himself, but he's still getting outs.
A ball and a strike now. Scherzer now 1-1. No contact there, and it's 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And he's going to add to the total. 14 punch outs now as that ends the inning. One left for Atlanta. They trail it here 4-2. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. A.J. Minter will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Johan Camargo is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number 17, Johan Camargo.
First pitch of the at-bat. Juan Soto is in to start things out as he swings and misses at that one at strike one.
Hey, either this hitter needs a cup of coffee or he was sitting off speed right there.
Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. And he'll just waste one there, 1-2. Here it comes.
I got to count 2-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Now here it comes. Changeup taken for ball three, well below the zone.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
The 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed. He got him.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
The speedy Trey Turner digs in now as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Trying to keep it going. A perfect 3-for-3 thus far. Comes set and the 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. And he won't go after the cut fastball, 2-2. Now here it comes. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate, Josh Bell. As he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Right there, and it's quickly 0-2 now.
There seem to be different philosophies on it, so Dan, what was your approach in 0-2 counts?
My philosophy is this. I think the last thing you want to do is throw non-competitive pitches, Matt. Throw something down in the zone or just out of the zone, but something way out of the zone doesn't serve any purpose.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. 1-2, here it comes.
Two balls, two strikes.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
Now the payoff pitch home. High in the air out to center field. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Three up, three down for Washington as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Ken O'Rainey has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 21, Tanner Rainey.
Leading off the inning, Christian Pache, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Christian Pache.
From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. And there are the final numbers for the Washington starter. It was a really nice day on the mound for him.
Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
So here's Johan Camargo as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Lifted in the air out to left. Schwarber is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Ronald Acuna. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. First pitch of the at bat.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. Gomes has it. The throw to first is in time and the inning is over. Down in order go the Braves. Still down by a count of 4-2. Number 68 enters from the bullpen to do the pitching.
Now pitching for Atlanta. Number 68.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. And next, the dangerous power threat, Kyle Schwarber. First delivery to him on the way. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
He's going to be thinking about that pitch all night if he doesn't have a big game right here. Pulled his front shoulder and everything went with it.
Count now a ball and a strike. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Now the 2-1 pitch is a slider taken for a ball.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth.
Now batter. The second baseman, Starlin.
Ready for another Castro. Shot now. Starlin Castro. He singled his last time up. Becomes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. And he lays off for ball one. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. A runner at first with no outs here. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Now a swing and a miss as Castro was retired here for the first out. So a runner at first now with one away, and that means the catcher Yan Gomes bats next. From the belt, the pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. Over to Albies. Relay to Freddie. Double play, and that'll end the inning. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Mark, Dan, and I are back with more after this. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Brad Hand comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Batting in the seventh spot, number 33, Brad Hand. Now catching and batting up.
Freddie Freeman will stand in again as we flash you back to earlier. He's accounted for their only runs of the ballgame on one swing of the bat, as this was the swing right here. From the stretch, ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Two balls and a strike to Freeman. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
And in a two-run game right here, you really don't want to walk the leadoff guy to start an inning. You've got to keep that tying run in the on-deck circle as long as you can.
The 3-1 pitch is in there for the second strike.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Striding in, Marcell Ozuna. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. From the stretch. And he pours this one in at the letters, 0-1. Nobody out, runner on first. And it's quickly 0-2. Again, another foul ball. The next 0-2. And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he sat down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. So a runner at first now with one away. And up next, the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud. He's set. Here it comes. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Max Scherzer in line for the victory, barring a late collapse here. Now a swing and a bouncing ball for Castro at second. To second for one. On to first, and he rolls a double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
Yeah, and they end this thing with style, turning that double play to preserve the win. That's what we call finishing strong.
4-2, the final score today. The Washington Nationals jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Max Scherzer takes home the win. Drew Smyly is only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon: for the victorious Washington Nationals, 4 runs on 8 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For Atlanta, 2 runs on 4 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. The winning pitcher is Max Scherzer.